The Queen kept rigidly to her timetable. At the LTA exhibition in West London, there was no outward sign that word of the drama in Switzerland had been passed on to her. As patron of the Lawn Tennis Association, she took a great interest in the exhibitions, which bring together for the first time all the varied interests that get involved in the game. Now, we've not had a men's Wimbledon champion, of course, since Fred Perry back in 1936, so it was proper that the Queen should meet the King of the English game.
It always is a great honour for anybody to meet the Queen, I think.
What would you say to those people who perhaps say that we might have to wait another 100 years before we get a men's champion like yourself?
I don't think you will. It's you know, nobody ever knows where people come from. They come right out of the blue. I did.
Women's tennis, of course, has been much better served. Virginia Wade won the ladies' singles in the Queen's Jubilee year of 1977. And our oldest surviving champion, Kitty Godfree, who won in 1926, was also presented. Tennis, of course, has had a major influence on fashion, and the royal visitors were given a fashion show of how tennis clothes have changed down the years. Where's our next champion coming from? The game of short tennis aimed at 7 to 10-year-olds could provide the answer. The Queen appeared fascinated by the soft ball that's used and thoroughly enjoyed the children's display. Right on time, Her Majesty left Queen's Club, and it still wasn't certain whether she'd been told of the skiing incident as she left for Buckingham Palace.